Alright, hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. For those of you guys that have not had a proper introduction, my name is Monica and this is my channel where I vlog and upload any type of documented videos that I want. I kind of just wanted to make this video to do like a follow-up update and kind of think how things have been going for my first trimester. I haven't been able to film a video in a really long time because of school and work, but right now I'm not having to go to work or school because of the whole issue that's happening in our world. So I'm given time right now to film a video, and I'm glad I get to edit a video because I haven't been able to edit or film in a long time. I was gonna do my hair and makeup, but I realized it would just have been a waste of time because I really haven't been able to do my hair or makeup lately. Like, I just been going with the flow and my makeup hasn't been a priority, even though I still enjoy doing makeup. Just haven't really been going anywhere to where I need to put makeup on. So I have a list of things I want to cover in this video, and if the lighting keeps going dark, I apologize. It's because it's cloudy outside and my windows aren't fully open because I just got over a mild headache and I don't want to put the light right on me. If you're interested in hearing about my first trimester and things that I have coming up for myself, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. And thank you guys so much for watching. Okay, so I kind of want to do like a recap before I go into like my first trimester side effects and symptoms and all that. So back in December of 2019 was when I found out I was pregnant. I found out the day after I missed my period for the very first time. So once my period didn't come on my set scheduled day that my app told me, I just knew something was up. And that morning I was getting ready for work and I just went ahead and, actually I was getting ready for a final. I went ahead and just booked an appointment at the school health center and I went right after my final, took a pregnancy test, and it actually didn't come back positive or negative. They actually told me I had to do like draw blood in addition to the urine sample. So I did that, and I actually didn't receive my results until the 19th of December, which was 2 days later. But I went home, well, I purchased the pregnancy test at home, not at home, at the health center, came home and took it, and knew that night that I was pregnant, even though it wasn't confirmed from a doctor. I just knew my body, and I just knew something wasn't right. So I went ahead and went with my instinct and just kind of went with it. I knew I was pregnant, and then the results came in on the 19th that confirmed I was pregnant. And at that point I was officially 5 weeks. The way pregnancy works is kind of confusing. So technically I thought I was only 3 weeks because my period was supposed to come and I did calculations and I was only 3 weeks from the time, you know, I had conceived. But for some reason, when you like the way pregnancy works, you actually add on 2 weeks from like the start, from like your last period or something. It's really confusing. I didn't understand it at first, but I guess that's how it works. I went ahead and then from then I made my video and I uploaded it, and I can't remember when I uploaded it actually. Let me see. I'm trying to think if I uploaded this video before I told my family or after. Okay, the day after Christmas. So at that point my family had already known, my close friends had already known. I just went ahead and shared the news because regardless of what would have happened, I just wanted them to be a part of it. From there I kind of had to just figure out what I was going to do as far as insurance, because I don't live in my home city with my family and the insurance I'm covered under was only going to be beneficial in that city. So I had to find my own insurance, and then once I finally did that, by the time I purchased the insurance, I had to wait for the cards to come in order to like make an appointment. So it was kind of a little stressful moment trying to figure out this whole insurance thing because I never had health insurance, on my own. So I had to figure out my insurance situation. Once I did that, I finally got to book an appointment, and then I had my first appointment with my OBGYN on February 13th, and then I had my first ultrasound, like official ultrasound. They gave me an ultrasound at that doctor, but they don't have like the right equipment to give me an in-depth ultrasound. So I had like a very small ultrasound on the 13th of February. Got to see the baby's heartbeat because in the ultrasound you can just see like the fluttering. And then my ultrasound at the other doctor's office was February 19th. And that is where we got to see the baby moving and taking lots of pictures, and we got to get a couple videos. It was pretty cool. And I can insert like a picture in one of the videos here if I'm able to download it, because my phone's a whole issue. That's pretty much all that like follows up until today. So I'm currently almost 18 weeks. So I'm 17 weeks and 5 days. So this Thursday I'll be 18 weeks, which I'm currently in my second trimester. But I wanted to film this video giving you guys an overview of how my first trimester of pregnancy went. So if you don't know, your first trimester is from the week, like your first week, all the way until your 13th week. So I'm already almost a month out of my first trimester. So a month into my second. And a few things, like a lot of people kept asking me, oh, like what are some side effects or symptoms, like pregnancy symptoms you're having? And to be honest, I didn't really have like much. Like every once in a while, I experienced nausea, but it would go away. Like I never had to vomit, I never had morning sickness. The only reason I would throw up was because whenever I was brushing like my teeth, my gag reflex was like super weak. So if I was brushing my tongue or if I hit like a spot in my mouth, it would make me nauseous, and occasionally I would throw up, but it wasn't from like morning sickness or anything. I experienced food aversions where some days there was nothing that sounded good. I would just be forcing myself to eat because I hadn't eaten, but also there was nothing that like was really like, ooh, this sounds like super good right now. So that's something I went through. Back in January, the very beginning of January, was when I started experiencing my headaches. And for those of you guys that don't know, I deal with really bad migraines. And in order for me to deal with those, I take medication. And once I found out I was pregnant, I actually had to stop taking that medication. So now my headaches and my migraines just come at their own will, and they put me through hell, but I just have to deal with it, because nothing I take really helps. I was told I could take Tylenol, but the Tylenol just makes me nauseous. And my migraines alone already make me nauseous and wanting to vomit, but the Tylenol just doesn't help at all either. So yeah, I would say that probably like everything with my pregnancy so far has been good. Like I feel like I've been trying my best to be healthy, even though I still eat crap. I try to eat vegetables, drink lots of water, eat my snacks and my meals. But the only thing that's probably been the biggest issue has been dealing with headaches weekly. And not just headaches, it's like very hard to explain. It's like a pain I get on the right side of my head that turns into a migraine that can last up to 3 days. And it's not fun because I'm trying to experience my pregnancy. And not only that, but I was working and going to school, so I had a lot going on. So to be hit with migraines almost every week, it was just really hard. I'm just glad like everything is working out right now, because I was gonna take some time off, like get a doctor's note, but now I don't need it because I'm off of school and work. Well, not school, but I'm off of work until the beginning of, well, like the middle of April. So I get to just rest and take time for myself. Like this morning I was dealing with a headache that I was trying to prevent it from becoming a migraine, and I did that. So now I'm feeling a lot better. So I'm just glad I have this time off to just deal with myself, figure myself out, and rest. That's pretty much everything I went through for my first trimester. Things that are coming up. So like I mentioned, I'll be 18 weeks this Thursday. Since I'm not working or doing much, I can maybe film some more videos. If you guys have any video requests, feel free to leave them down below so that I know kind of what videos you guys want to see. And then my second ultrasound, where I'm hoping to figure out what, like if I find out the gender or not, won't be until the beginning of April. So hopefully in the next few weeks, we're figuring out what we want to do and how we're going to do it. So I'll keep you guys all updated as long, along with my family. But if you guys have any suggestions as far as like how things work when you're pregnant and all that, go ahead and leave those down below. Yeah, so that's the end of this video. I want to say thank you again for all those new subscribers and for those of you guys that watched my first pregnancy video. It was exciting to see how many people viewed it. It is one of my most viewed videos on my channel, and I thought that was super cool because I've been making videos for a while and like on and off of this channel. So like to see a video like do good, it made me happy. Go ahead and insert clips of my belly. go ahead and show you guys how I'm looking right now. So I look normal. Okay, so this is my belly right now. I 17 weeks. I feel bigger than I look, I think. I feel huge after I eat, especially. But yeah, that's my stomach. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, don't forget to like it. Subscribe if you aren't already. And I'll see you guys next time. Deuces.